Hello everyone. Today we will learn chapter number 4, ADO.NET, and in that our topic will be ADO.NET Connected Data Access. I am your instructor Kruti Patel from LG Institutes of Engineering and Technology. First of all, we will see what is ADO.NET Connected Data Access. In connection-oriented data access architecture, the application makes a connection to the data source and then interact with it through SQL request using the same connection. In these cases, the application stays connected to the database system even when it is not using any database operations. In connection-oriented data access, when you read the data from a database by using a data reader object, an open connection must be maintained between your application and the data source. Now we will see connected classes, which is used while we are doing the program of connection-oriented data access. The following classes are used by ADO.NET to communicate directly with the data source. First is connection. It maintains the information required to connect to the data source through a connection string. The connection string maintains information such as the name of the data source and its location, and authorization credentials and settings. Second is command. It executes SQL statements or stored procedures against the data source. Next is data reader. It provides connection forward only and read only access to the data source. It is optimized for speed. The data reader is instantiated through a command object. Next is data adapter. It bridges the data source and the disconnected data set or data table classes. The data adapter wraps the connected classes to provide these functionalities. It provides a method to retrieve the data into a disconnected object and a method to recloin modified data in the disconnected object with the data source. Next, we will see how a practical demonstration will be done of connected data access. For it, I'll open Visual Studio. And I'll open a program which I have done thoroughly in Visual Studio. As you can see, it is a code for connected data access program. For it, now I will create database for storing data in your table. You can see here, I have taken one database in Solution Explorer priorly. I'll zoom in this screen. You can see here database 1.mdf is already attached here, but I'll show you how to attach this database and how to create a new table in this database. So first of all, I'll delete this database. So right click, delete, and here database is deleted permanently. Now I'll create a new database. So first of all, you need to add the Solution Explorer tab. If it is not shown in your screen, you have to add it from view. So in menu bar, you should go for view and you can add Solution Explorer here. So you can see here Solution Explorer is displayed in your screen. So first of all, I'll add a database. For that, I'll right click on the project and click on add a new item. You can see here, when I click on new item, the data items are displayed here. So I'll go for this data tab, and you can see here The one of database is service-based database is mentioned here. So whenever I click on the service-based database, it display me a name database1.mdf here. I'll press add. After adding this database1.mdf extension, you can see this database is asked for data storage entity. So I'll choose dataset, press next, and here dataset name is assigned automatically, and now click on finish. You can see here your database1.mdf is added in this solution explorer. So database1.mdf, it is our database. Now I'll add table in this database. So first of all, for that I need to add server explorer. So I click on view and server explorer. You can see here the server explorer window is displayed here. Here server explorer, and our database is database1.mdf. So I'll right click on this database1.mdf, and you can see whenever I click on this database1.mdf, tables are displayed. So whenever I right click on table, click on add new table. Now add the column names. I'll take two column. First column named ID, its data type is integer. I'll take second column name, its data types is varchar, means variable character, and I'll press Control S. Whenever I'll click Control S, it will ask for table name. Here default table one is displayed. So I'll write here student, which is my table name. After writing the student, press OK. You can see here in tables, a student table is added. Now to add the data in student table, I'll right click on table and click on show table data. So here initially null values are displayed. So I'll enter random two or three rows in this student table. So I'll write ID, that is 1. Which is integer. I'll write name, that is Kruti. My second value is second ID, that is ID 2, and name is KHP. I'll add 3, and name is Ram. And now I'll press Control S, which will store data from data in table. Now I close this table definition and table data. It is a program.cs file. Now we will see how to write a code and which classes are called for calling this stored table data in our console application output. For it, first of all, here you can see I have added these two data types, two namespaces, which are using system.data, and second one is system.data.sql client, as we are using here SQL database. So here you can see a first line is a connection string, which is stored in S variable, which is type of string. So here where to copy this connection string? So first of all, in server explorer, you need to right click on database1.mdf and go in properties. You can see here property window is displayed. So Here, one of the properties connection string. So double click on this connection string and control C and copy this in our S variable. Control V. Remove these double quotes which is inside this connection string and write double quotes in starting and ending of this connection string and lastly write semicolon. Now here I have written SQL connection class and for that I have taken SQ object. So SQL connection, SQ equals to new SQL connection. Now connection is open through the method open, which is method of SQL connection class. So I have written here sq.open. Now our next class is SQL command. So here I have written SQL command, object is cmd equals to new SQL command and in round bracket a command is patch which whatever the task we want to do in our database. Now I'll want to print this all data, so I'll write the select query. So here I have written select star from student and second argument is our connection object, that is nothing but the SQ. So here note these parameters. While creating the object of SQ, you need to pass connection string, and while we are creating the object of SQL command, we need to pass command as well as connection object. Next is SQL data reader, which will read a data from console. So here I'll take a class SQL data reader. Its object is reader equals to cmd dot, its method is execute reader. It is nothing but the method of SQL command class. Now I'll take while loop. So while a reader dot read means that whatever the data which is in our database, it will be read by this reader. This line will be executed and this line is nothing but to print the data column wise in our console output. So here console.write line reader 0 and reader 1. Here this index is number of this index is nothing but the number of columns in your database. So here you can write in curly bracket 0 and curly bracket 1. So curly bracket 0 will display column 1 and curly bracket 1 will display column 2. Now here your connection is closed. So sq.close method is written. Last line is console.read line. So it will print a data in your console output. Now I'll run this code. You can see your table data is displayed in our console output. That is 1 Kruti, 2 KHP and 3 RAM. It is nothing but your table data which I have stored prior only. Now if I want to insert a data in that particular database in our student table, so I'll write here insert command in place of select. So here I'll copy this line. And I'll comment this select line. So here you can see SQL command cmd equals to new SQL command and here I have written code to insert data in table. So our syntax is like this: insert into student table values 4, which is ID and PHK in single quotes because it is a data of string, and round bracket in double quotes separated by comma. I'll write here connection object, that is SQL. So now I'll run this code, but you cannot see your output because I have not written select line, but data will be added in your student table. So right click on student table and click on show table data. You can see here your table data is added. I'll zoom in this screen. You can see 4th PHK is added in your table. Now, next is your delete command. But first of all, before we'll delete, we'll do update. So I'll comment or I'll remove this insert line from here, and I'll add this in update command. So here your update command is update student set name equals to ABC, where name equals to Kruti. Here, wherever it will find name Kruti, it is replaced by ABC. So now I'll run this code, but here we don't add it select line, so I'll show this updation in student table. So right click on student and show table data. You can see here my name Kruti is replaced with ABC letters. So in such a way you can update your data which is stored in table. And last command is delete. How to delete a particular row? So for that, I'll remove this update and I'll copy this delete line, which is nothing but delete from table name where your ID equals to 1. So first row will be deleted by this task. So I'll run this code, and in table you can see right click show table data, and here the ID 1 is removed by compiler. So in such a way you can see how to insert, delete, update the data which is in our table. Now I'll again write select command. So uncomment this select line and I'll run this code. You can see here it is displayed, which is inserted, deleted and updated by these compilers. Okay, so it is nothing but a code of connected data access in ADO.NET. Thank you everyone.